In San Diego, you'll see a man named Bill Munsey driving this boat in an attempt to make powerboat history, to win the famous Gold Cup for the fifth time, thereby tying the record of the sports immortal Gar Wood. The job won't be easy. The energy and resources of nine other boat crews will be pitted against him. At speeds of more than 150 miles an hour, Munsey, Bill Sterren, and Gene Chenoweth will also be fighting it out in the final race of the year for the National Drivers' Championship. Stay with us then on land, in the air, and at sea on ABC's Wide World of Sports.
Being a male and being vain like most males, you want to do something well, and you want very much to win. And because you enjoy the attention, and you enjoy the glamour, and you enjoy certainly the notoriety.
Presented to Bill Munsey.
Well, I've been racing a long time, and I'm a professional. And I drive very well, and I drive well-prepared equipment.
We will have passes from 9 to 11. Each 1A will start at 12. Does anyone have any questions?
And I'm quite capable of winning on a par with anybody else who's capable of winning.
Coming up in 15 seconds. 15 seconds countdown.
I think I've enjoyed it for a long time. Since I've been able to understand what fright is, and since I've developed, this was years ago, such a great respect for the mechanism, I don't think I really enjoy it.
You really don't know that you're moving as quickly as you are, and you're not really aware of the wind against your face or the speed.
And Bill Sterren is, in my opinion, is the toughest chauffeur that I've ever run against. And he really doesn't have to take too many chances to win, because from experience he's going to drive well. And I know this. I have great confidence in his ability. You have to give Leif a great deal of credit. In my opinion, they're probably the fastest boat in the race today. Well, of course, Dean is... He's just, to me, an exciting, stimulating, excellent driver who has had great experience. He's from Ohio. Great experience in all kinds of boat racing. He's just he makes all the right moves. He's not particularly emotional about it, and he's clean, and he's tough. And great respect for him. He's a brilliant young man. In our society, you know, men aren't allowed to come up and let another man know how they feel about it. And maybe you may have strong feelings about a male that, gee, I like this guy, he's a great guy, and he has so many qualities that I admire. But all you have to do in a situation like this is just look at the other fellow's eyes, and you know that he has great confidence in your ability. My crew thinks I'm the finest chauffeur in the whole world. They just don't, there isn't anybody better. I gotta go. This is the Gold Cup, and there's no pressure like Gold Cup competition. This is the end of a season, the 1969 season, where the Drivers' Championship, National High Point Championship, and the Gold Cup Championship are all up for grabs, and I happen to be in contention. Last year, I didn't make it. I wasn't running that well. Here we are in San Diego, and a good performance in this Gold Cup is very, very important to me.
I've been frightened most of the morning. I just always seem to be that way. And concerned about
10 seconds.
The uncertainty, I think. We'll be in the money for a second or third. I feel quite confident about it. You know, the older I get, the more I've been wondering about my Sunday afternoon activities. I think that maybe I should reconsider, see if I can figure out something. I think it's just because you're so uptight, and your system is, the adrenaline is moving through. It's quite an experience.
Leave you with your thoughts, Bill. Thank you.
At the wheel of that brilliant red boat, Miss U.S., is Bill Munsey of Seattle, Washington, one of the most famous names in the history of powerboating. Going into this final race and the most prestigious race of the year, the Gold Cup, Muncy is one of three men who still has a chance for the yearly Drivers' Championship. That's a most unusual circumstance. Usually the championship for the year is all wrapped up by this point. But he is in second place behind Dean Chenoweth, and just behind him is Bill Sterrett. Whoever wins the Gold Cup today most certainly will win the Drivers' Championship. Looks like an interesting afternoon.
Five boats are nearing the start of the first heat in the 1969 Gold Cup. This is Jim McKay reporting from Mission Bay in San Diego. And when that clock goes completely black, it will be the official start of this heat. The idea as the boats move into this scoring up area here is to time your speed so that you hit the starting line just as it goes all black, not before and not after. Five boats here. Bill Muncy in Miss U.S., Fred Alder in Miss Bardall, Bill Sterrett in Miss Budweiser, Tommy Fultz in Pride of Payenfack, and Walt Cade in San Diego Mist, headed for the start. On the near side, he's trying to pay it back. Tommy Fultz looks like he's going to take the lead if he's not too quick. It's okay. It's a good start. Tommy Fultz is trying to pay it back, headed into turn one. In second place is Bill Muncy in Miss U.S., who had a real good start. He was flying as he hit the line. In third place is Miss Budweiser. That's Bill Sterrett. Remember now that Muncy and Sterrett are two of the three men battling it out for the National Driving Championship for this year of 1969. The field of 10 boats has been divided into two groups of five each. This is the first heat with five boats in it. And there is Tommy Fultz on turn two coming out. Bill Muncy, a very strong second. Miss Budweiser spreading her way through the field in third place right now. And at this moment, a very clear third. Very misty here on Mission Bay this afternoon. A kind of a fine California-type haze settling down on the course. There is Fultz. Look at the foxes leaping out of the water. They say that only 4 square inches of these boats are on the water when they are moving perfectly. Also on today's program, remember, you'll be seeing the National Parachuting Championship and the United States against Italy boxing matches. A wild and woolly afternoon. A crowd estimated at 100,000 people gathered on the banks of Mission Bay, a completely man-made lagoon made especially for big boat powerboat racing. And there's Bill Muncy in second place. The scoring system here is 400 points if you win a heat, 300 if you're second, 225 for third, 169 for fourth, and 127 for fifth. Total points for the day's activities to determine the winner. Tommy Fultz right now, just in his second season in unlimited powerboat racing, and amazingly, driving a boat that is in its first race today. Most unusual for a brand new boat to make this kind of a showing. Still a long way to go, however. And there is Muncy in Miss U.S., four-time winner of the Gold Cup, out after a fifth. Trying to tie the record of Gar Wood, the fabled gray fox of Algonac. And now here comes 65-year-old Walt Cade in San Diego Mist. 65-year-old man in the race, just out of him, Miss Bardall. This is the boat that's won the race the past 2 years, driven by Fred Alder, having its troubles in the early going today, but now moving up and trying to pass Walt Cade. And there he goes, flashing by San Diego Mist. Up in front again, look at Tommy Fultz. Tommy used to be a drag racer, and that's kind of his style to this day. He's really flat out, particularly on those straightaways. His first lap speed, by the way, was 106.509. That means he was doing better than 155 miles an hour on the straightaway. Still in second place, here comes Bill Muncy flying out of that turn. But gaining very fast from both of the leaders is Bill Sterrett in his Miss Budweiser. He's really flying now. All of these boats, by the way, powered by either Rolls-Royce or Allison airplane engines. The Rolls-Royce is the kind that were used in the famous Spitfire planes during the Battle of Britain in World War II. The Allison's used in the American P-38 fighter plane. There's a look from overhead at the leader, Tommy Fultz in Pride of Payenfack. Beautiful sight on the blue waters of this man-made hydroplane racing lagoon on Mission Bay in San Diego. There's Muncy in second place, and there you see Bill Sterrett in third place. Definitely a challenger at this point. Remember that he and Muncy are two of the three drivers still battling it out for the Drivers' Championship. And with several heats to run today, it could be as important to them here to finish second, possibly as to finish first. It looks like Tommy Fultz, barring trouble with his boat, has first place pretty well wrapped up at this moment. There he is, taking a look over his left shoulder. Well, he might, because
You never can be absolutely sure of anything with Bill Muncy and Bill Sturrett coming up behind you. And Sturrett's trying to pass Muncy on the inside on the straightaway, and he's got him. He tried to pass him on the turn, but you don't do that to Bill Muncy. But flying out of the turn, Sturrett was able to get out in front. As a matter of fact, it looks right now as if Miss U.S. may be slowing down. So the combination of tremendous speed by Sturrett and slowing down by Bill Muncy has caused a change in the standings. Now down through water level again, and there's the leader, Tommy Fultz, in spite of Pay Impact. Bill Sturrett in this Budweiser. On the last lap, by the way, 2 miles an hour faster than the leader. And in third place still, Bill Muncy. But Miss U.S. is having trouble. He's definitely going slower. Those are the three leaders, however. 400 points at stake here for first place, remember. 300 for second, 225 for third, 160. And look out, spinning into the infield is Mitch Barnall, driven by Fred Halder. And now he's going to try to pick up that buoy, very quickly recovering, and now moving slowly out around, trying to re-accelerate, pick up the buoy, stay legal in the race, and get going again. Okay, back on the court. Black and yellow checkered boat, and now it's slowing down and stopping. You know, what could have happened there, he might have been going just too slow in picking up that buoy, not getting enough water to cool his engine through, and he may have burned something up. However, that's just conjecture. Here again is the leader, Tommy Fultz. He has a real habit, if you'll notice, of stealing looks over his left shoulder. And there is Budweiser still barreling along on the inside, going inside a buoy. Budweiser may be out of the race. Bill Sturrett went inside. Inexplicably, one of the buoys on the backstretch is now back on the course, but he did not go back and pick up the buoy as Fred Alder had just a few moments earlier. So, if the ruling is against him that he went off the course, it certainly looks like he did, he can be disqualified from the race. Now, here's a replay of that incident when Sturrett strangely went inside the buoy and off the course. You can't imagine why it happened, but here is the moment. Either Sturrett simply made a mistake, lost control, or was forced over by another boat. We'll just have to stand by for an official ruling. Now back to the race, and Tommy Fultz, in front of Pay Impact, is headed for the finish line. He is clearly going to be the first place finisher in this first heat of the 1969 Gold Cup, the race whose traditions go all the way back to the year 1904. Budweiser will be the second place finishing boat, and right now we're trying to get word from the judges' stand. There is the winner waving to the crowd, Tommy Fultz in front of Pay Impact. And here comes the word, the judges did not see it. They say they did not see Budweiser go off the course. He is okay, and Bill Sturrett officially finishes second, gets 300 points. Bill Muncy finishes third and gets 225 in this first heat. Now, coming up in a minute will be the second heat. Five different boats, remember, and in one of them will be Dean Chenoweth, the third man, still fighting it out with Sturrett and Muncy for the National Drivers' Championship. There's the winner of the first heat again, Tommy Fultz, and we'll be back in a minute. Again, we return to the waters of Mission Bay in San Diego for the second heat in the 1969 Gold Cup race. The boats drawn for this heat were Dean Chenoweth in MERS Special, Blake Borgerson in Notre Dame, Jim McCormick in Atlas, Mike Wolfbauer in Save Air's Probe, and Bob Gillum in Mr. Pease. However, Mr. Pease was not able to get underway and is not out there now. There are, in fact, about 2.5 laps left in the race, and it's a tremendous battle between Jim McCormick, the leader in Atlas, and Blake Borgerson in Notre Dame. And in third place is Dean Chenoweth in MERS Special. And there is Notre Dame on the outside, trying to gain on Atlas. Borgerson style seems to go more to the outside and then to cut the buoys close. And there he goes. He's going to blast by and into the lead. It looks like Borgerson trying to take Jim McCormick, and he does. Notre Dame is the new leader in the second heat of the Gold Cup. With me right now as we watch is Bill Muncy, who is not in this heat, of course, having finished third in the first one. Boy, this is real racing here, Bill.
Jim, this conceivably could be the fastest heat of the day. Both boats are very fast boats in the straightaway, and they corner well, although they're quite susceptible to bad water. When they get into bad water, they have problems, and they sometimes turn... There, Leif Borgerson's trying to get off with the use of what we call laughing gas, the same thing your dentist uses, and to make that 7,000-pound boat move at a speed of 150 miles an hour fast with the kind of pressure he's got on him from Jim McCormick and the Atlas Van Lines, you got to work kind of hard, and you've got a good battle going here.
Tremendous battle. Two quick questions for you about the first heat, Bill. First of all, looked like you slowed down. Did you have engine trouble?
We did, Jim. Oil in an engine engine has to go through the system. The scavenge line came off, so the oil stopped going through the engine and it just loaded up the engine with oil and we couldn't turn it.
There's Notre Dame, still the leader. The last lap, 109.356 miles an hour, the fastest lap of the day so far. And there's Atlas still chasing him. My second question was, did you see Bill Sturrett miss a buoy in that first heat?
Yes, Jim, I was running just a little ways behind him, and it's very easy to see. I could see that he missed two buoys, in fact, in the same straightaway.
Okay, well, that was back in the first heat. The judges decided otherwise. They said Bill Sturrett did not see him miss the buoy, and so he got his 300 points, which eventually could determine the Drivers' Championship of the year. Now, Dean Chenoweth, right here, is running in third place in this heat. He is the leader in the overall Drivers' Championship. Bill Muncy, second, and Sturrett now moving up much closer with his 300 points in the first heat.
I think it's important to remember, though, this Gold Cup race, and that's what we came here to do, is run for the Gold Cup, is a four-heat race. If you're going to win it, you've got to complete the four heats, and you better be third or better. So Chenoweth is a cool, sharp chauffeur. He'll sit back there and cool a while and hope somebody busts, that otherwise he'll pull his third. And maybe when the traffic isn't quite so fast, he'll pull a second or a first.
Okay, in other words, each boat here will run in three heats, and then the top five to that point will go into one final. Bill said it's a long afternoon here on Mission Bay in San Diego as Notre Dame appears to be flashing to victory in the second heat of the 1969 Gold Cup. There's Notre Dame going through the fourth turn. This is the final lap, and here comes Atlas, also headed for the finish line. A good finish for Jim McCormick. And in third position, as we pointed out, Dean Chenoweth coming to the finish line now. And Notre Dame's going to win it. 23-year-old Leif Borgeson, youngest driver in the race, getting the 400 points that goes with first place in this heat. Jim McCormick in Atlas getting 300, and Dean Chenoweth in MERS Special gets 225. The third heat of the 1969 Gold Cup is about to get underway, but here is the story of the moment. Bill Muncy will not make it to the starting line. His engine has broken down, and there you see a very disconsolate champion. The other boat's out there, however, right now, as the clock is just about to go to all black for the start of the race. And there you see, pay it back, that's Tommy Fultz in the middle, but coming on the outside, close to the camera, is Notre Dame. Notre Dame taking the lead on the start, and in second place is MERS Special, driven by Dean Chenoweth. Third place is Tommy Fultz in Pride of Pay and Pack. As they go into the first turn, however, it is Dean Chenoweth taking the lead, and there that half-red clock that you saw indicates that somebody jumped the gun, and it had to be Leif Borgeson in Notre Dame. So he is automatically one lap behind. In other words, technically, he hasn't even started the race yet. In third place right now is the old man of the sea, 65-year-old Walt Cade, right here in San Diego Mist. So to spell this out once again, the leader is Dean Chenoweth in MERS Special. Second place right now, Tommy Fultz in Pride of Pay and Back. Third place, Walt Cade. And in fourth and last place, although he appears to be battling for the lead, is Leif Borgeson in Notre Dame. Here is Dean Chenoweth, the leader in the race, leader in that three-way battle for the National Drivers' Championship with Bill Muncy and Bill Sturrett. And in the booth right now comes an unhappy Bill Muncy. Too bad, Bill.
Jim, it just seems that the best laid plans and preparation can occasionally go astray, and there's some consolation in the fact that we've had a real good year.
Okay, well, I hope you can watch this heat with us, even though you're not in it. There's Pride of Pay, in fact, with Tommy Fultz, which is in second place at the moment behind Dean Chenoweth. Notre Dame, if you weren't watching before you came in the booth, jumped the gun, Bill.
Well, there's one thing about it here. This is a tight battle for first, and certainly a tight battle for points. Leif may have been signaled from the judges' stand that when the clock blacked out halfway, that somebody jumped the gun, and he probably darn well knows that he did it. On the other hand, he doesn't know whether maybe he pulled somebody with him, and if he did, and it was Chenoweth, he's got to keep running with Chenoweth, hard as he can run with him, to see if he can't get by, and maybe if they did both jump the gun, at least in points, they'll end up ahead of the first special.
It sure looks that way right now, and that's a very good point. We have the official word, of course, that it was just Notre Dame that did jump the gun in this heat. And now Notre Dame slowing down. Yeah, coming to a complete halt. I have not seen in a long while as many breakdowns as we seem to be getting so far here today, Bill.
It just seems to be the pressure of Gold Cup performance, and everybody wants to run the very best. Of course, here's the Pride and Pay back with Tom Fultz, and it looks like...
Yeah, he's off the course now. This is another one.
He's coming into the pit area.
His engine's smoking. I don't see any flames as yet. Yeah, there is some fire in that engine.
Jim, there's some flame.
Yeah.
Jim, it would appear this is the kind of thing wherein he picked up something in his pickup pipe, the pipe that sticks into the water that we use for getting cooling to the engine, and that maybe he just wasn't getting the cooling and he cooked the engine, literally cooked it, and it was... Because I don't see any more fire. Where the fire... There's the fire.
Yeah, and Bill Muncy is with us because his boat broke down before this heat began. Now we have Tommy Fultz out of it, and we have Lake Borgeson and Notre Dame out of it. In fact, there are only two boats left out there. Dean Chenoweth, who is the leader, and 65-year-old Walt Cade of San Diego Miss, who is now right here in second place in this heat.
And of course, Chenoweth's IBM brain will start computing this thing and saying, hey, I'm running in first place, I'm picking up 400 points, I'm going to cool it. And he'll sit back and run lap speeds of maybe around 98 to 100 just to keep alive and keep up front.
Okay, well, he's in the last lap right now, is Dean Chenoweth. And there is Notre Dame right in the middle of that turn. You know, if there was real tough racing going on, that'd be a dangerous place to be, wouldn't it?
I know just how he feels. And you move from the front. Last year, I got run over by a houseboat sitting just like that, minding my own business. I couldn't imagine that anybody would do that.
Well, this is no houseboat out in the water right now. That is MERS Special, driven by one of the geniuses, as you say, of the Gold Cup driving world, Dean Chenoweth. Headed for 400 more points. He got 225 points for a third place in his first heat. He'll have two more heats to run after this. His third heat of the day and then the final in which only the top five boats compete. So Dean Chenoweth is the winner of the heat. San Diego missed second and they were the only boats to finish this heat. We'll be back to see how it all turns out. Right now on to Keith Jackson at the National Parachuting Championships outside Tucson, Arizona. Thank you very much. Well, one heat remains in the 1969 Gold Cup race here in San Diego. Unfortunately, Miss U.S., piloted by our friend Bill Muncy, will not be in the final heat, but in a way, that's our good fortune. I hate him to call it that, Bill, but we will have your services as commentator for this final heat. The way we see it, point-wise, all that Bill Sturt and Miss Budweiser has to do to win the Gold Cup is to finish the race. It looks like a race for second place, then, between Jim McCormick in Atlas and Tommy Tucker Fultz in Miss Pay and Pack.
True, the Budweiser has to only finish or conclude the heat. That's all he has to do to win the Gold Cup. But Bill Sturt, to win the National Drivers Championship, has to run third, or he's going to lose.
Well, here's a look at how they stand. Gold Cup on the left, Bill.
Bill Sturt's in first place, Jim McCormick's in second place, and Tommy Fultz is in third. In the run for the National Driving Championship, in first place is Bill Sturt. Dean Chenoweth is in second, and I happen to be still in competition for third place. It's anybody's boat race, and really, should Sturt bobble, it could be anybody's National Driving Championship. And with the pressure of Gold Cup competition and possible mechanical failure, well, who knows?
Bill, you're within one heat of the dream of every unlimited driver's lifetime, the winning of the Gold Cup.
Yes, it appears on paper that all I have to do is finish now to win it. And we had a fresh engine for every heat. They put me in a fresh engine. Just doesn't look like there's too much could stand in their way. But the owner has already said he's going to, unless I agreed to run dead last this time, he's going to put in a substitute driver.
You sure wouldn't want that when you're right on the verge.
No. Of course, he was just cutting up. He lets me drive the boat the way I see, but it would be foolish for me to go out there and break the engine or to do anything that would keep me from finishing at this point.
And pulling out of the pits is the only man with the chance to catch Sturt for the driving championship, Dean Chenoweth. Back in a minute to see what happens. They're headed for the start line in the final heat of the Gold Cup. Bill Sturt and Miss Budweiser, Dean Chenoweth in MERS Special, Jim McCormick in Atlas, Tommy Fultz in Pride of Pay and Back, and Walt Cade in San Diego Miss. It's going to be a good start, and taking the lead very quickly is Dean Chenoweth in MERS Special, Tommy Fultz in second, but now being passed by Jim McCormick in Atlas as they go for the first turn. Dean Chenoweth still fighting for the National Drivers title with Bill Sturt has taken the lead. There he is in this very distinctive, unusual-looking Gold Cup boat.
Jim, let me tell you, Dean Chenoweth had nothing to lose and everything to gain by pushing the clock a little bit, making a real flying start at about 160 miles an hour. And he had to get to that first corner first. He has to virtually win this heat and hope beyond hope that something will happen to Sturt. This would improve his position in the race, of course. And you've got competition flying like you've never seen before here.
So it's
saw the first three go through, but there is Bill Sturrett really cooling it in last place, just as he said he would be, in Miss Budweiser. All he's got to do is get that thing to the barn, and he has the Gold Cup wrapped up. However, the Drivers' Championship's still on the line. And here's the fellow who's fighting for it, remember, Dean Chenoweth in MERS Special. And as we look across the course, Tommy Foltz has pulled into the pit, so he is out of it in Pride and Pay, in fact, just that suddenly. And now this boat, San Diego Kiss, suddenly moves into second because Jimmy McCormick has pulled into the infield in Atlas. The only two boats that had an outside chance of winning the Gold Cup have both dropped out within 3 or 4 seconds of each other, Bill.
And Jim, with all this action, the Budweiser, the wise old guy that he is at this point, is sitting back there cooling it, winning the boat race on the way to the bank.
Here briefly is a look at the way the speeds in the Gold Cup have increased. Look at that 1904 CC Riot. Only went 23 miles per hour. Gar Wood at 56 miles per hour in 1921. Guy Lombardo in 1946 70, then up to 99 with Lou Fagel in 1954. 108 in 1968 with Bill Shoemaker.
All along the way, Jim, there in those, in the interest of historical reference, we've had a lot of improvements in engines and hull design, and it's exciting and quite unusual to consider what may be the future of our sport.
Well, there's a look at the fellow who's going to win this heat. It looks like Dean Chenoweth, and they really are hydroplanes flying on the water.
They are, and that shot gives you a good, accurate idea. You can see that little bit of light come down underneath the boat, which gives you an idea that the wind is moving down underneath the boat. It is really a water-bound airplane. It rides on 3 square inches of wetted surface on each sponson and one blade of a two-bladed propeller. Now, at 12,000 revolutions per minute with one blade out of the water, you can see the rooster tail as we see it on the Budweiser here on the left. Just a flying back there, and it can at times be quite a vicious weapon. Not that the drivers use it on purpose, but it is there.
Well, Bill Sturrett, with the Gold Cup all wrapped up, seems to be trying to prove a little bit that he's still fast. He's going to win the Drivers' Championship as well by finishing second in this final heat.
The High Point Trophy is, of course, quite critical, but here we have a boat that's dead in the water. The Atlas
Jim McCormick.
Yeah, with Jim McCormick, and he is out of contention for this particular heat.
A quick reminder here, football tonight, Mississippi against Alabama, 9:30 Eastern Daylight Time on most of these stations. Dean Chenoweth getting the checkered flag and winning the final heat of the Gold Cup. However, he finishes second both in the Gold Cup and in the National Drivers' Championship on a basis of points to this boat and this man, Bill Sturrett in Miss Budweiser. He wins the Gold Cup, 1969. He wins the National Drivers' Championship, a tremendous achievement for this 45-year-old Kentuckian. We'll be back to watch Sturrett savor the thrill of victory in a minute. There's nothing like the moment of victory, and this is it for Bill Sturrett.
Congratulations.
Hey, where you been?
I've been watching.
You can have 3 days off.
Oil-spattered coveralls and second place this time for Dean Chenoweth.
You went around all the buoys and everything else all day.
And for Bill Muncy, driver of Miss U.S., bitter disappointment in his quest for a fifth Gold Cup championship. He'll have to wait till next year.
And you want to hit the best competition head on, really every chance you get, because then when you conclude it, and if you do in fact win the Gold Cup, it's a marvelous feeling to win.